Davison Figueiredo is the new surging UFC flyweight champion who is making a name for himself as an exciting and brutal finisher. Not so long ago, it seemed like the flyweight division was going to be cut from the UFC entirely, and once Triple C retired, leaving a vacancy, it seemed sure to come true. Figueiredo brought a new wave of excitement to the division with his 85% finish rate with 9 knockouts and 8 submissions. With his quick dispatch of Alex Perez just a couple weeks ago, he tied Demetrius Johnson for most finishes in flyweight history. And the kicker? He tied the record in only 10 UFC fights, while Johnson had 18 UFC fights in his career. Figueiredo is looking to continue his streak of violence while he defends his flyweight throne. In this video, we will break down the stats and the science behind Davison Figueiredo. Figueiredo stands at 5'5" with a 68-inch reach. He is average height for the division and has 2 inches on the average reach. Let's start by taking a look at Figueiredo's striking. He's one of a select few flyweight fighters who hold true devastating knockout power. He has the most knockdowns in the division's history with 8. He's not just a mindless brawler looking for the knockout shot though. Figueiredo does an excellent job at getting the timing and the range of his opponents down. Once he does, he loosens up and fights with his hands low by his hips and employs crisp head movement to evade his opponent's strikes. But even if they do land, he doesn't seem to care too much and uses it as an entry for sharp upward elbows or uppercuts. He has a significant strikes landed per minute stat, 2.79, and a 55% striking accuracy, and a significant strikes absorbed per minute of 2.82 with a striking defense of 52%. By keeping his hands low, he makes it difficult for his opponents to see the strikes coming. Figueiredo isn't too big on lengthy combos and prefers one-and-done type of engagements with his strikes. His favorites are his hooks, especially to the body, and has dropped opponents with them. Sometimes after getting his opponents focused on the body hooks, he'll switch to an uppercut. Switching between the body and head is a key strategy of his striking style. Figueiredo tries to keep his strikes unpredictable. Throwing just one or two at a time is difficult for the opponent to know what's coming, and every strike has power behind it. To make this more effective, he constantly pressures his opponents towards the fence or forces them to circle towards his power hand. If Figueiredo ends up in the clinch, his goal is to break and create distance so that he can get back to striking. The clinch is a chance for his opponents to rest, and why would he want that? If he gets too close to the clinch, he'll either frame off his opponents to create distance or use his elbows. Figueiredo is an excellent scrambler, and if he gets into a position he doesn't want to be in, it's very difficult to keep him there. Speaking of scrambling, let's take a look at his ground game. Figueiredo isn't just a solid striker, he sports an excellent ground game to back up his stand-up. He has a takedown average of 1.68, takedown accuracy of 50%, and takedown defense of 63%. He also has the highest flyweight submission average per 15 minutes of 3.02. Figueiredo has a crisp double legs that he does with ease when paired up with his striking. Although Figueiredo has excellent grappling and wrestling skills, he doesn't like to use it offensively too much, and prefers to use it defensively to punish his opponent's mistakes. This allows him to stay loose with his striking and not worry too much about his opponent's offensive grappling. One of his best techniques is his guillotine choke, which he likes to grab off of his opponent's double legs or in guard. 5 of his 8 submissions come by way of the guillotine. Figueiredo is a hard man to pin down and is explosive off the ground with his scrambles and sweeps. Combine that with his guillotines and submission game and you see why he doesn't care about being taken down. His fluid movement on the ground isn't just for defense though. He employs powerful ground and pound to finish off downed opponents or soften them up enough for a submission. On the feet, on the ground, or somewhere in between, a god of war is always dangerous. At the time of this video, Davison Figueiredo is scheduled to fight Brandon Moreno for a second title defense, mere weeks after finishing Alex Perez in the first round. He's an exciting champion that we look forward to see continue his reign, and maybe one day move up to claim another belt. Before we wrap up this video, we just wanted to announce our new Discord MMA community. The server is dedicated to all things MMA, from fight discussions, sharing memes, jokes, and more. The link to join is in the description below. Thank you for watching our video. If you enjoyed, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe for future content.